Hello and good morning, CTS 266, Section 840 students for the spring 2016 semester at Anne Arundel Community College. This is the Cisco Networking Academy CCNP switch course, and this morning's video tutorial is going to be on a lab we're going to be attempting tonight in class. This is Cisco Netacad Lab 6-2, where we're going to be taking a look at HSRP v6. So to give you a quick glimpse of the architecture that we're going to be dealing with, we're going to have many more components involved this evening than we typically do. So as you can see here, we've got three routers. We're going to be in a pure IPv6 setup, right? So we are not doing dual stack. There is no IPv4 involved here along with the IPv6. And we will be running EIGRP v6. For those of you that had the route course with me, it's going to be up to you as to whether or not you'd like to do the named mode with EIGRP. Or if you'd just like to do the regular IPv6 router EIGRP configuration commands. So what I've done, and we're going to refer back to this here, what I've done, you'll notice that they have you rewire all of these connections between the switches. Now, this is 100% unnecessary because we already have those ether channels, or I should say those physical connections, are already established. So if we're dealing with ALSW01 and DLSW01, if this is what we're dealing with right here, right, which is what this lab entails, and then you've got a host hanging off here on FA018, and this is just our Windows host, and I'm using a Mac today. This is the setup that we have. So instead of recabling everything, just simply use FA07 and 08 between ALS1 and DLS1. Use 09 and 10 between ALS1 and DLS2, and then use 11 and 12. And that's what I've done in this lab. Again, it doesn't make much sense to completely recable your rack so that you're using the interfaces they have here. It just doesn't make any sense. So go ahead, leave your racks cabled the way that they are, and just make the changes to where this is going to be FA 07 and 8, this is going to be FA 11 and 12, and this is going to be FA 9 and 10. And you're going to achieve the same mileage that you would in terms of functionality, and you're going to save yourself a ton of effort having to uncable the way it is now, recable it like this, only to have to undo all this as we go forward and into some different labs. So you can certainly leave the cabling the way it is. Again, they're using FA05 here to connect into router 1 and router 3. Okay, so what I've done is I've saved us probably 30 to 45 minutes of time. All of the basic configuration is already done. So all of the VLANs are already configured. All of these VTP settings are fired up and ready to go. And we are actually going to pick up on step 6, which is what this lab is all about. And that is configuring HSRP v6 for IPv6. And so we're going to pick up on DLS1. Now, quick note, if you remember from the previous video, in order to get that VRRP information working, I had to upgrade to 12.258 SE2. Unfortunately, that was an IP base image. And another lesson learned is that with the IP base image, you cannot run EIGRP v6. So the command just wasn't there, right? Name mode's not there because that's a 15.x train feature. And IPv6 router EIGRP wasn't even there, right? You could only do OSPF and RIP. So I had to downgrade back to the IP services image. So again, I'm at 12.255 SE10, but this gives us the EIGRP v6 non-name mode configuration, but again, it gives us the functionality excuse me, that we need in order to be successful here. All right, so again, IP show IPv6 route EIGRP. So all the routing has already been set up. You can see here that we've got all kinds of routes that we're learning via EIGRP. And so we're going to go ahead and dive in right now into the HSRP v6 configuration. And we're mostly concerned with VLAN 99. That's where we have the host plugged in. However, we're going to be setting up HSRP for all of the VLANs. And you're going to see that it's similar, if not almost identical. I mean, there's really one command that's different, and that's the command that's going to help us generate the IPv6 link local address, right? And that's going to be that standby and then the group number IPv6 auto config command. And we put that HSRP group number in there, and then what that's going to do is it's going to automagically give us the virtual IPv6 address. So instead of us configuring the address, we use autoconfig, and autoconfig is going to give us the address, and we'll see what that looks like. I also have, and where's my VNC viewer? So we also have access to the MacBook here that is connected up to... So here is the MacBook that we're using as our host. You can see that we're going to be changing this here so that it sort of automagically picks up its information. And we'll come back to that in a second. So let's go ahead and let's start out with interface VLAN 99. And again, the first thing that we want to do is remember that with HSRP v6, we need to have standby version 2 or HSRP v2 enabled in order to support IPv6. The next thing that we would do is we would say standby, give the group number, and this is where if I say IPv6, if I do a question mark here, you can see that I can put an address in, and I'll do this on some different VLANs. However, I could just simply say obtain address using auto configuration, and this is going to be the easiest way to do it. Again, there's nothing wrong with me putting in an address. And you can certainly do that, but autoconfig is a much quicker way to make that happen. So DLS W01 is going to be the primary, right? So it's going to be the primary for group number, HSRP group number 99. So I'm going to set the priority to 200, and then we're going to say standby preempt. And this doesn't change, right? Excuse me. And you can see that we just went from standby to active. So now we are the active HSRP router for VLAN 99. Okay, let's go ahead and go into interface VLAN 100, and we're going to do much the same thing here, right? We're going to say standby version 2. Standby version 2. I always forget the group number. Standby 100 IPv6, and let's go ahead and we'll stick with autoconfig here, and then we're going to say standby 100. Preempt. Now, remember, we're not the active router for VLAN 100, so we're going to leave it just like it is, with the exception of I'm going to always use standby 100 priority is going to be 150. All right, so then we're going to scoot down to interface VLAN 110. Interface VLAN 110. You can see we've gone to the active state there, but that is because there is no other HSRP router right now. So in interface VLAN 110, we're going to say standby version 2. We're going to say standby 110 IPv6 autoconfig. Excuse me. Standby 110 preempt. Standby 110 priority is going to be 200 because we want to be the active router. And that is it. Now in interface VLAN 120, and much the same, right? Standby version 2 because we're doing IPv6. Standby 120 IPv6 autoconfig, and you can see we've just transitioned to the active state there for VLAN 110. Standby 120 priority is going to be 200 because we're going to be the active router, and then standby 120 preempt. All right, and then our final VLAN, which was the voice VLAN that we had configured, interface VLAN 200. So standby version. Standby version 2, do show run int VLAN 200. Let's make sure there. All right, good. So standby version 2. We've got standby 200 IPv6 auto config, standby 200 preempt, standby 200 priority is going to be 150 because, again, we're going to be the standby router, and DLS2 is going to be the primary router. So that takes care of our configuration. So let's see, what does that look like? So we'll say show run and begin at VLAN 1, and that puts us right down at the switch virtual interfaces. You can see VLAN 1 is shut down. We're not doing anything there. There's no IPv4 addressing here. This is all IPv6 addressing. So let's take a quick look at what we've got on the DLSWO1 side, and we'll look at VLAN. We'll focus on VLAN 99 here. So here's our preempt command, right? Now, we could have put some delay information in there. We didn't. Maybe we'll do it on the other side. Standby 99 priority is 200, right? I always like to use 200 and 150 for my standbys, 200 for the actives, 150 for the standbys, and then I decrement by 51. And then here is the command, again, that generates automatically for us an IPv6 virtual address. Again, it's that same address that in IPv4 we would have said standby 99 IP 192.168.1.1. So this is the IPv4 equivalent of, and equivalent in the sense that it's going to give us an address, right? That we're assigning the address here, and that the standby 99 IPv6 auto config is going to generate for us an address automatically. And then again, critical here that we have this standby version 2. Got to have the standby version 2 in there because we are doing IPv6, right? That is what we're all about here, is IPv6 on this HSRP v6. All right, let's go ahead and clear our screen there. And we'll take a look at the rest of the config. And you can see pretty much the same, right? We've got the version, auto config, priority gets set if we're the primary. We're even setting it on the secondary. And then we've got our preempt command in there to ensure that things get preempted. And so real quickly, I want to make sure I'm consistent here. Interface VLAN 99. So if I were to say standby 99 preempt and do a question mark, you can see we can still do the delay minimum 270 and then for a reload 270 seconds. So do show run int VLAN. Oops. Int VLAN 99. That's the Cisco best practice there, to allow the routing protocols time to converge, right? Again, that equation that we're using there is assuming that it's a 3-minute window for the router to reboot, so 180 seconds. You take half of that and then add it to the time it takes to reload. So if the reload time is 3 minutes, 180 seconds, half of that is 90 seconds. 180 seconds plus 90 seconds gives us that 270 second number, and that's what we're using there. All right, so now let's go ahead and get things fired up here. Let me save that. We've got quite a bit of information there. And let's say show standby. Let's see what we've got. So as you can see, we've got a new MAC address, right? And it's actually telling us here, and there is that virtual IP. And if you were wondering, is this a modified EUI 64 type format? It absolutely is, right? There's that FF colon FE, and here is the MAC address. So if we were to do EUI 64 with this, what would this look like, right? So here's my MAC. And excuse me. So we've got 0005. Make sure we get this right. 73 alpha 0, and I should probably stay consistent here, dot 0063. So this is my MAC address. So remember, with the EUI 64, we go to the 7th bit, right? So these are hex characters, so the bits here are going to be 1234 and then 1234. So we find the 7th bit, which is that guy right there. If it's a 0, we're going to flip that bit to a 1. So what's going to happen is this MAC address is going to change. It's going to become 02, right? Because that value, that bit position is a 2, 05.73A0.0063. Now remember, I said it's a modified EUI 64 because if you look up here, right, we don't see this 2, do we? So with normal EUI 64, we would do this, right? But take a look up here. Is that happening? No, that's not happening. In fact, there's the 5 is that guy right there. So this does not happen when we are generating that virtual IP address. We're simply going to take the MAC address, right, which we had here, and in the middle of the MAC address, we're going to put in FF, FE, which we did, and then that's it. I mean, we're literally going to put FF, FE in the middle here, and then there is our interface ID. We now have our 64-bit interface ID, and then we're going to append, or I should say prepend, the 64-bit prefix of FE80 colon colon, and there would be, you know, three sets of all zeros in here, and we're just trimming this down with the rule of zeros, and then we pick up right here, right? So I don't need those zeros, so I can just say 5 colon, and then what comes next? 73 fox fox colon, and then you can see we've got the FE we need, so FE, and then what follows that is alpha 0. Make sure we stay consistent here. And then after the FE alpha 0, we've got two zeros that we can drop. We've got colon 63. So there is the modified EUI 64. And again, the modification is that we are not flipping. No, we are not flipping the seventh bit. With regular EUI 64, we flip that seventh bit. Had we done that, this would have been in that hextet right there would have been 2, or was that right? Let's see, that would have been 205. Yeah, would have been 205, right? But it's not, because we're not flipping the seventh bit. So this is how HSRP V6 is coming up with the virtual IP address. And again, this is a virtual IP that is automatically being generated with a modified EUI 64, right? And again, the modification is that we are not flipping the seventh bit. So there's no flip, right? No flip. We simply insert FFFE into the middle of the address. That gives us our 64-bit interface ID. And then we prepend the 64-bit prefix of FE80 colon colon. And again, we're representing three sets of all zeros there. Okay, so again, you can see we're running version 2 IPv6 default, right? That's the default for IPv6 is going to be we're going to need to run version 2. Here's our preemption delay of a little over 4 minutes, right? And if we reload, it's also going to be 4 minutes. So standby router, it's unknown, right? Because we haven't configured DLSWO2 yet. Our priority is 200, and it's configured for 200. And again, we're focusing here. Let me draw down the line here. We're going to focus only on VLAN 99. And then we have our default group name. So the active router is the local router. That means that that is us, the router that I am running this command on. Now, take a look at the hold and hello timers. Exact same values, right? 3 seconds for the hello time, 10 seconds for the hold time. And this pretty much wraps up a quick look at what we're going to be seeing here before we bring DLSWO2 online. So let me go ahead here. I'm going to clear the screen. Remember, again, critical, it's modified EUI 64. So basically we're doing the exact same thing we would do with the EUI 64, except we don't have to worry about flipping the seventh bit. And super convenient, right? Because this is kind of a hassle sometimes when you're dealing with the MAC addresses that you run into. All right, so let's go ahead and clear our screen here, and we're going to come back onto the command line, And let me make sure, just one more time here, save that config. You can never be too sure. All right, so now we're on DLSW02. And before we do that, let's go ahead and kick off debug. Let's see, IPv6, is it IPv6? No, it's gonna be debug standby. There we go, debug standby. And we're gonna debug, and actually let's see here, this is gonna give us packets. I don't think we want these packets. And take a look at those virtual IPs, right? You see those virtual IPs down at the end, how the last two hexadecimal characters, right, are representing what? Exactly, they're representing the group number, but they're being represented, they're representing the group number in hexadecimal. So I don't want to see all of that. Let's go ahead and pull this back and let's say debug standby. I want to see errors. I want to see, I don't want to see packets right now. Let's see events. Oh, wait a second. Errors, events, and packets. Display limit range. Well, no, we're not going to do terps. All right, so we'll do errors and events, and that should give us what we're looking for. Again, just a little more verbose output to tell the story as to what's happening. So let's go into global config interface VLAN 99. Do show run int VLAN 99. And there we go, right? So everything is configured already with the addressing. So let's go ahead and dive in here. So it's going to be the same thing. Standby version 2, standby 99, IPv6. Now remember, I could put an address in here. So let's do that. Let's come over here and let's see what is the virtual IP, right? So I could actually cut and paste for VLAN 99 that value right there. Copy, paste. And that's the virtual IP I'm going to use, right? So you can hard code that in there. So standby 99 preempt, and let's say, oops, sorry, standby 99 priority, since we're the secondary, DLSW02 is going to be the standby HSRP router. I'm going to put the priority at 150. And so that should give us everything we need. And you can see here, we've got some, there we go. We got our state change syslog message. We went from speak to standby. If we come over here, we got a little additional information from our debug, which is always nice. So neighbor, and you see it uses that link local, advertisement inbound, VLAN 99 neighbor created. And let's see, standby router is going to be FE80:Delta 2. And it's no longer passive, right? Because he is actively participating in HSRP, and he is now the standby for group number 2. So if I were to say show standby, not default, so show standby brief, so what do we see? Well, we see right here that for VLAN 99, it's group 99, the priority is 200 here on DLSW01, preemption's enabled, we are active, so who's the active? It's local, and then who's my standby? The standby is FE80:Delta 2, and here is that virtual IP address, right? And again, the reason that you would want to go ahead and say auto config is that it would use the same address, because what if I were to make a mistake? What if I said no standby with that address? And what if I came back and said that the standby is going to be 64? You can see we're in the disabled state now because we took the address off. So what if I put a different address in here? What if I put in address 64? Well, we should see some activity over here. So the standby router is unknown. It was FE80:Delta 2. And then we went into a passive hold down, right? Waiting for that timer to expire. But take a look here. Active router's virtual IP is different from the locally configured address. Now what's interesting, and maybe we're gonna see that over here, is that we're not seeing that over here on DLSW1. Even though we're debugging errors, we're not seeing that. What if we were to do, maybe it's in the packets. Let's take a look and see in the hello packets if it's gonna give us any information here to indicate that it's receiving hellos. And it doesn't. So it's interesting that we don't see the error here on DLSW01. I mean, we see the fact that we're getting the hello, right? And it shows us the virtual IP, which is incorrect, but it doesn't tell us that it mismatches. Yet over here, we are seeing that that's the problem. And it could be because DLSW01 is active and that this is the standby. So let's go ahead, we'll sort that out. Let's say Control A, no standby, and then we'll fix it and we'll put it back to 63. So again, we went from disabled. Now we should transition from disabled to the standby state here. Let's see if we see anything over here. No, we're still looking at the power. Oh, the debugging's off. Sorry about that. So let's do debug standby events, and then we'll take a look at errors. All right, and there we go. We went from standby to disabled, and then speak to standby. So here, if I say do show standby brief, this is what we see, right? So for VLAN 99, group 99, our priority is 150, preemptions enabled. What is our state? Standby. Who is the active? Gives us that link local address, FE80 colon colon delta 1. The standby router, who is it? It's the local router, and there is our virtual IP. And again, it's that automatically generated virtual IP that we got from the auto config command on DLSW01 that we've now just cut and pasted here. All right, so let's go ahead and finish up our config. Let's go to interface VLAN 100. We're going to say standby version 2, and then standby 100 IPv6 auto config, and then standby 100 preempt, and we are the standby. So we're going to say, standby 100 priority is going to be 150, and then same thing, interface VLAN 110. It's going to be standby version 2. Standby 110 preempt. Standby 110 priority is going to be for VLAN 110. Are we the primary? Oh, and I'm sorry, for VLAN 100, I think that we are the primary. So I'll fix that in a second. For 110, we are not. So the priority is 150. And then standby 110 IPv6 auto config. Whoops. Auto config. So do show run int VLAN 99. Let's compare VLAN 99 and VLAN 110. So we should have the version, the auto config. Oh, well, we had cut and pasted it in there. The priority and our preempt. Now for VLAN 100, int VLAN 100, we're going to say standby 100 priority is 200 because we are going to be the active router. And you can see we went from speak to standby and then standby to active. So let's knock out these last two VLANs here. Interface VLAN 120. We're going to say standby version 2. And let's see what happens. If I don't put standby version 2 and I say standby 120 IPv6 auto config, what does it do? It gives us that message. HSRP version 2 is required for IPv6 support. So, oops, sorry. Standby version 2. And then standby 120 IPv6 auto config. Standby 120 preempt, standby 120 priority is 150 because again we are not the active node, and then interface VLAN 200 where we are going to be the active node is going to be standby version 2, standby 200 IPv6 auto config, standby 200 priority is going to be 200, and then standby 200 preempt. And that should do it. So let's go ahead and say end. Let's save this so that we don't lose it on a reboot. All right, and let's go ahead and say show standby brief. And what are we looking at here? So exactly what we would expect, right? We've got our different virtual IPs that are showing over here. You can see that each of the groups is listed there. There are the priorities, right? 200 being the active, 150 being the standby. You can see that we have preemption enabled. And here is our state, right? So the 150s are going to be standbys, the 200s are going to be active. And then who is the active router? It's going to tell us. Who is the standby router? It's also going to tell us. And so we've got all of the information that we could possibly be looking for. in terms of just a sort of a brief output here, most importantly, we're seeing that virtual IP, again, that was automatically generated for us when we did that standby group number IPv6 auto config command. But again, you don't have to use that command. You could pick an address, any address in that FE80 link local range, as long as it's the same address on both sides. All right, so configure interface tracking. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and set up some interface tracking. Now remember that with HSRP, the interface tracking is actually built in to HSRP, so we can simply get away with saying standby the group number and then track. And so here's what we're going to track, and let me pull up. Let's clear the screen here. Let's pull this diagram up again. So here's what we're going to be tracking for VLAN 99, 110, and 120, for which DLS1 is the primary. We're going to be tracking FA05, and it makes total sense to track this HSRP interface right here because if that link goes down, I do not want host traffic coming this way because with that link down, there's no way out of the network to get to router one. We would want DLS2 to take over active HSRP router status so that all traffic flows this way to get out of the network. And that is going to be the address right there that we're going to be trying to get to. And this loopback zero here is just simply simulating the internet, right? So we're just simulating the internet with that. So let's track the interface, and then we're going to kick off some or track for the three VLANs here on DLS 01. And then what we're going to do is we're going to kick off a continuous ping and then fail some of the interfaces. So here we are back on DLSW02. Let's transition to DLSW01. You can see that we've got all of our groups and messages set up here, or our debugs are kicking off there. So let's go into interface VLAN 99. And again, this is one of the nice things. It's just simply standby 99 track. And all I have to do is say fast Ethernet 05. Now, remember, what else do I need? Oops, sorry. Fast Ethernet, standby track, fast Ethernet. It should be. Oh, I'm sorry. It's 105. My bad. Fast Ethernet 105, and then the decrement value. It's always good to know which interfaces you have on your switches. So, and then the decrement value. So again, I always decrement by 51 because that takes it to 149, which is going to be one below what it needs to be. Now let's do the same thing for interface VLAN 110. We're going to say standby 110, track fast Ethernet 105.51. We should see some debug activity there. And the interface VLAN 120, the exact same thing, is going to be standby 120, track fast Ethernet 105. Whoops, 105, decrement by 51. So do show standby brief. And that means that all of those 200s that you see here, right? Anything with a priority of 200, so VLAN 99 that we set up, 110 and 120, those would get decremented by 51 if fast Ethernet 05 or 105 goes down. So now let's test this out. We've got our host, right? So let's pull up our host. So here's our host. Now, this is kind of a sidebar conversation, but let's watch what happens here. I'm going to say auto magically pick it up and click OK. If I come back to advanced, you can see, actually, we'll clear this out here. So we'll say OK. Whoops. So automatically. So we automatically want to try to pick up an address, and for some reason, it's grabbing. There we go. That's what I was looking for. So, and you can see right away the pings picked up. Now, here's what's interesting. So take a look. What router address are we using in VLAN 99? Exactly. We're using the virtual IP that was created that floats between router or DLSW1 and DLSW2. right? So worked perfectly on the host end, just like we thought. And as you can see, our pings are working as well. And so I'm pinging that 201 colon colon 2, which is that address that is out here, 2001 DB8 Cafe 2001 colon colon 2. So let's take a look and see what happens here when we kill the interface, right? So we're simply going to take down fast Ethernet 05, and let's see what the impact of that's going to be. So interface fast Ethernet 105, and I'm going to say shut. And you can see we're getting all kinds of information. The track object was picked up immediately. And what do we expect to see over here? And this is a little more consolidated view that we went from standby to active. And take a look. In less than a second, all three of these flipped over to being active on DLS WO2. So show standby brief. And you can see that the priority here for 99, 110, and 120 is 150, right? And that's good enough to become the active HSRP node, do show standby brief, because on VLANs 99, 110, and 120, our priority over here decremented down to 51, exactly as we had anticipated. All right, so the final step of this lab is going to be to optimize HSRP v6 for adjusting the hello and hold timers used in the HSRP communication. And so what we're going to do is we're going to adjust it to 50 milliseconds, and then a hold time, and the hold time will be 250 milliseconds. In other words, 5 times the hello time, which is okay, right? You can certainly do that. Remember, the hold time is simply the value that the router is going to wait before declaring the HSRP relationship with a neighbor to be down. And so this is kind of super aggressive here, setting it that low, because let's take a look. On DLS WO1, if I was to say ping FE80 colon colon delta 2, and the output interface is going to be VLAN 99, right? You can see that it works. But take a look. Our average was 1 second. The max, I'm sorry, 1 millisecond. The average was 9 milliseconds, right? So if you had some serious latency where these numbers were 200 and 300 milliseconds, this is probably not something you're going to want to implement. And again, there's a reason that the default timers are set to the values that they are. Make sure that your use case, is going to support dropping those timer values down. So let's go ahead and we'll do that. We'll just do it for, we're not going to do it for all of them. We'll just simply do it for interface VLAN 99, because that seems to be the one that we're dealing with here. So we're going to say standby 99. I'm going to do a question mark. You can see we've got this timers value, right? So standby 99 timers, and then milliseconds, right? Specify the hello interval in milliseconds. We're dropping it all the way down to 50 milliseconds. And then we've got milliseconds again for the hold time, which we're saying is going to be 250 milliseconds. And it's a good thing I've got the, I believe the debugs are off. And we're not debugging the packets anyway, so that's okay. And that's it. So that's going to drop my timers down to millisecond values. So if I were to say debug standby packets, and this is probably going to crash the router, but that's okay, because we're going to wrap up here. Actually, before we do that, in order to see these values, if I said show standby for VLAN 99, this is where we're going to see that those values are set. And you can see it gives us the default, but it shows me what are they configured at. So the defaults are 3 and 10, but I'm configured for 50 milliseconds and 250 milliseconds, right? So very, very aggressive timers. Let's actually match this on the other side. So we're gonna say interface VLAN 99, and then standby, oops, sorry, standby 99 timers, millisecond is 50, millisecond 250. All right, so now the timers match on both sides. Do show standby. And you can see, where are we at here? Yeah, So you can see that now it doesn't show that configured because we're set the same on both sides. Before, when we weren't set on both sides, right, what was going on? We were being told that it was 3 and 10. So this is a great opportunity to see that the active router will tell the standby router what the values should be if in fact they're different. And that's exactly what we're seeing right here, is that the values were different between the two routers. So the active router, who in this case is DLSW02, because Fast Ethernet 105 is down, he was telling DLSW01, yeah, I see that you're configured for 50 and 250, but we're using the defaults of 3 and 10. So now let's do this command again, and we should not see different values, and we don't. So let's go ahead and wrap this up by seeing just how quickly these messages go by, if in fact they are, sorry, not standby. So I want to do a debug, standby, packet. All right, hold on here, you all. So that's how quickly, I mean, take a look at that for VLAN 99. It is generating a bunch of messages there. You can see three sets before we see four, five, before you start to see any of the hellos for the other HSRP groups. And so again, these are happening. I just killed the debugging, but we're probably gonna have some shadows coming out here that were still running, that were buffered. So again, let's make sure we can kill this. All right, so that covers the HSRP V6. Again, there's gonna be quite a bit to do in this lab with respect to setup, just to get yourselves down to part two, or I should say down to step six, really, is where you're going to want to, you start to get into the HSRP configuration. So there's quite a bit to do with respect to the setup. So make sure that you focus on that, because if that doesn't go well, the HSRP part will definitely not go well. And as you can see here, it looks like we may be powering this router off and powering it back on. This is what happens sometimes when you've got so much debug output coming to the screen that there's nothing you can do to control it. All right, well, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all this evening. Have a great day.